dear people, welcome to this new episode of Creating Dark Velvet. I would like today to tell you something about what I can assume will be one of the signature pieces of the CD, and that is a piece of Isidora Zebeljan, Ej Duso, or Oh, Die, My Love. It is definitely the most excited 3 minutes I had to work this last year on, because it involves violin, piano, and my own voice while I'm playing. And it is, of course, for somebody who is not a trained singer, a challenge. But I asked for it myself because I was totally obsessing about this piece. It spoke to me a lot at the time when it was written. And since I was a very good friend of Isidora's and I spent a lot of time with her and was present when, I think also when this piece was composed. It's originally a composition for a voice and the orchestra, or voice and piano, or voice and a quartet. And it has become a very, very famous piece also to be transcribed, because it's really, truly, remarkably effective and very emotional. So it's a 3 minutes roller coaster about a woman that is obsessed about her beloved and would rather see him dead than not marry him. It's originally the sixth song of Rukoveti, that is a collection of folk poetry, and it's the one that says, "Oh, my love, die, die, my love. I will die too. Anyway, we are not gonna get married here. Die, die, my precious. I will die too. And then we will marry somewhere else in heaven, for sure. And die, because I would rather kill myself than marry somebody else." And in these 3 minutes, while this goes from the most tender, loving expression of love, it goes into this wild, possessive female energy of, like, it's fatal. There's no negotiation. We are gonna die, because if there's no other way, that's it. Fascinated by this piece when I heard it being performed in an original version, and I said to Isidora, "Oh my God, you know, this would be my life achievement, to be able to perform it for violin, piano, and my own voice, because my mother being a singer, I have been very curious about singing myself and wanted very much to experiment, like, how that would feel." And she did it. And it was created in 2011, the transcription for me. But it took me until 2021 to start working on it, also singing-wise. So I really worked on it the whole year to be able to do it, because it's very, very difficult to control all this together. And mind you, it is not an easy piece. Isidora's music is always very, very rhythmically complex, and it's mathematics that you have to do to be able to perform it. But the core of it is so much folk-like music that when you discover the layer, when you don't count every 16th or every 8th in the bar, then you start to get her musical expression and the very clear folkloric element and the folkloric movement in it. And so it took me some time to decipher this on violin, but then afterwards I had to really start note by note discovering how I'm gonna orient my singing voice and the line of my instrument, because it is not the same line. And it is really remarkable what a human brain can do, and what capacity of concentration and what we can get used to thinking about in our brain. So it was really inspirational to think also further than just this act, what you can do with your brain. But to go back to this, it was like first separately learning, of course, the two voices, but then putting it together. It was also very, very interesting. It was a very interesting process, because the brain always listens to voice much more than what the ear can hear from the violin. So in a way, first I had to cut the cord and create two brains which can follow both activities. And then after that, little by little, giving the violin more and more automatic pilot, so that, you know, I could sing also the expression of the voice. And so then after that pilot here, I little by little started to feel that it is one instrument which lives in my brain, and it's created by my body in two totally in with two things, but in one way. So then now I'm actually in a phase where I can think about it. Oh, what do I want to do with the music in its totality? So yeah, and that's really, really fun. But just to demonstrate a little bit, I won't bother you too much with playing this on my own in front of you. But like, for instance, at the beginning, as I said, it's totally tender and the most loving call of a woman that wants to greet and wants to call her beloved.
Thank you.
on and on and on, and getting more and more excited and more rhythmically complex and harmonically building up step by step into a new harmony. And then it gets like the absolute catastrophe, and that is where she just starts saying, I would love to kill myself rather than love somebody else. And that involves octaves on the violin, which is actually quite a sport on its own, because it involves a total dedication to the sound, in my belief, like... like you have to be totally with your whole body involved in creating the right sound, so the octaves are in tune. But then I also have to sing and not the same pitch. So that is really the most difficult part of this. Then there is, of course, the aspect that the violin is being held here while you have to sing and be free in your head and throat and mouth and so. And that's actually an amazing learning process as well, on getting the ultimate freedom in your body and very little limitation on being totally focused and stuck on your fingers and hands. So here's just one little really like slow motion moment on what I have to actually do. I hope that you could enjoy and follow a little bit what was happening here. And I can only say I'm incredibly grateful to have the opportunity to explore all this and put all this together. And I hope you will follow the progress further, and see you soon. Bye bye.